All right, so you'll notice that I'm not in my regular setup. I'm on vacation with my wife in a small cottage near the beach. So what better movie to watch than the new Polish cottage mystery on Netflix, In for a Murder? Should you be watching? Magda, a naturally curious woman, accidentally discovers the body of a murdered woman in a park one night. The deceased has a pendant around her neck, identical to the one belonging to her long-lost friend. Magda then begins her own investigation, leading to many different suspects. Okay, so this felt a little like a longer Murder, She Wrote episode. The film has the feel of a movie that you'd see in like the 50s or early 60s, especially because you have the backdrop of a murder playing out, while whimsical and quirky music plays, all the while we have this bubbly protagonist working an investigation as an amateur sleuth. There's a lot wrong with this movie. The funny thing is, I had fun with it. Magda as our lead is very charismatic and charming. She's inquisitive and good-natured, but her curiosity gets the better of her and sometimes places her in harm's way. But that nosiness can work in her favor as she goes about examining clues and following her intuition. There's a bumbling detective on the case, and he's a bit arrogant and dumb. His interactions with Magda are strained because she's pointing out obvious clues that he really just should have picked up on. But there's also a history between the two, as they've known each other for a long time. So some of that antagonism just comes from familiarity. Now this feels like it's missing a lot of development on Magda. We learn of her history with the detective over the course of this story, but as far as her inquisitiveness goes, that's pretty unexplained. There are also small moments of understanding that the townspeople just have with Magda. Now I felt like I was left out of part of the conversation when it came to explaining her. Maybe some of this is because the story is part of a mystery novel series. I'm sure there's more detail contained in the novels themselves, as is typical, but the movie definitely lacks a bunch of detail and development on Magda. But if you overlook that and just go with her character being a curious person, then it's not hard to get into the story. The mystery itself is mildly engaging because while there is a case of the murdered woman that Magda discovers, there's also a personal mystery that is reopened for Magda. And this one is emotional for her, but again, it's shallowly explored. I think this movie is trying to dive in too much for the time allotment that they had. Now in the novel, I'm sure the story goes way deeper into each arc, providing not only details but the emotional pull and backing for why this is so important to Magda. Because she is such a charismatic character, I found it easy to sympathize with her and was willing to go along the journey, even if I didn't have all the details. The mystery is also fairly obvious, again playing out similarly to an episode of Murder, She Wrote. The peril is mild, the suspense is not terribly tense, but the feel of the story was surprisingly engaging. I love how Magda wears very bright and colorful outfits, which then contrasts nicely to the darkness of the murder. It's very odd, but it's a satisfying contradiction. And Magda is pretty bubbly and enthusiastic. She's quirky, upbeat, despite some of her circumstances. So even when she's investigating this death, she's sort of happy-go-lucky in her approach. I wonder if more of the novels will be adapted into movies, because this really does feel like the start of a series. We're introduced to the character, we get some backstory on her, and we get to know her surroundings just a bit. Other side characters are brought in that feel like they will be integral to Magda's story later on. Now, I enjoyed the banter between her and several of her acquaintances because it's mildly humorous and it gives us insight into all of their personalities. One character that I love to hate is Magda's husband. That dude is hot garbage and a trash person. He's chauvinistic, rude, self-absorbed, and he treats Magda in a way that we just wish terrible things to happen to him. And I do like that there is some resolution to this arc, though, which it felt good and natural. So like I said, this movie has a lot of problems to it. The characters don't have a lot of development, even though we do learn about them as the movie plays out. The two mysteries that are examined are shallowly developed, semi-obvious, and they're without much weight. There's mild suspense, but for the most part, the tension is always broken by something that's lighthearted, taking away any real sense of peril to the narrative. And despite all of these issues, I still had a smile on my face as the movie concluded. Magda is charismatic and sympathetic. She's a protagonist that I want to see more of. And even if all of the potential future adaptations are as simple as this one, there's a comfort that comes from the familiarity of such an uncomplicated murder mystery. It's got some nostalgia for me, as I remember sitting down on the couch watching Murder, She Wrote with my family on a Sunday evening. This won't be for everybody, especially if you're looking for great intrigue, twists, and story complexity. But if you want something light and fun, maybe give it a try. There's no sex or nudity, some profanity, and some violence. I give In for a Murder 3 out of 5 couches. Do you enjoy lighthearted or simple mysteries? Are there any in particular that you gravitate towards? I'd love to hear about them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this review, please give it a like. Also, don't forget to share and subscribe. I'm Chris. This is Movies and Munchies. Thanks for couching with me.